Last month, the chairperson organizing committee for the Non-Aligned Movement and G77 summits, Lucy Nachove, made it clear that government this time around will not procure new cars for the summits, but rather they will depend on the already existing government cars in good condition, in addition to those that will come in as donations. The Chinese government listened to the cry and has today donated 70 protocol car vehicles. The vehicles have been handed over to the government officials in Kampala from the Minister of Transport and Minister of Foreign Affairs.
This is the model of the vehicle.
This donation has increased the fleet of motor vehicles from China to Uganda to 140, all intended to see that the forthcoming summits move on smoothly.
Firmly supports Uganda in hosting the 19th NAM summit and the 3rd South to South summit. A high-level delegation of China will represent the country to attend the summits. I believe and wish this summit will be a grand event for developing countries to enhance solidarity and achieve development together.
The Chinese ambassador to Uganda, Zhang Lizong, noted that China will next week dispatch experts to train the Ugandan technicians and drivers and as well provide maintenance services for the vehicles.
No matter how the international landscape has evolved, the China-Uganda relations have remained rock solid. China would like to work with Uganda for closer exchanges at all levels and in various fields, continue to deepen political and strategic mutual trust, consolidate the foundation of bilateral ties.
Shortly after receiving the vehicles, the state minister for the Ministry of Works and Transport, Musa Echweru, hailed China for always giving a hand to Uganda.
Our meeting will be successful. The country should know that we'll be very ready by January. The country should know that we'll be very ready in everything. The security will be adequate. The infrastructure will be available now that you have catalyzed the process by making this work. Your Excellency, thank you.
The Permanent Secretary for the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Vincent Bajire, disclosed that the government needs a total of 1,200 vehicles for transportation of the guests during the summit.
Business is concerned. The country is extremely ready to host these two summits. As you can see, in regard to transport, we have these vehicles, now 140 vehicles that were donated by the People's Republic of China. We have vehicles that are in ministries and departments. All these vehicles are going to be recalled to be utilized for the 10 or so days that the summit shall be running. Additionally, the airport, renovations at the airport are the tail end. They are almost complete. The hotels are ready to host. We've held several meetings with them, and they are indeed ready for hosting. We have arranged a health committee that has taken care of the health requirements of the activity. We are confident that the meeting will take place and that the meeting shall be successful.
Under the theme, Deepening Cooperation for Shared Global Affluence, the NAM and G77 summits will run between 15th to 23rd of January next year. The summits expected to attract over 120 member states. This will be the second biggest summit to be hosted in the country after the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting, which was held in the country in 2007. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.